Dragon Blade that we are going to screen tonight at Paris Film Festival. So we can start with the questions.
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely. Go ahead.
Okay. We have Oksana from Slovenia. So please go ahead. So we have Italian and also English translations.
Okay.
Okay, please go ahead.
Hello?
Okay.
I work for Urobop, it's a website for entertainment in Italy. We're working for north of Italy, more or less. This is the first question for you. How do you feel about Americanization of Chinese culture? For how long do you think it will be possible for China to preserve its unique ancient culture?
Yes.
其實一路以來我自己已經嘗試將我們 long time ago I tried to bring the Chinese culture to America, so that was almost 38 years ago, but then doesn't success. I mean, at that time it's a big draw. The Cannibal Run and the Protector. I use a Chinese action, Chinese culture. It doesn't work. I think it's the wrong timing. But 30 years later, it's not I'm going to America, it's America invite me. So when I go to America, I still do the same kind of action, same kind of comedy, as the right timing, right moment, the right movie. So it's a rush, like a rush hour to break big success. That means, I think in America it's a free country, they like everything. But when you bring something in, just are you bring the right timing, the right moment, that's all. And right now, of course, right now China is probably, I don't know yet, is it probably the biggest market in the world, I don't know. And I think it's a time to bring not only American culture to China, we should bring the whole Asia, everything in China, or like I cooperation movie with Korea, with Japan, with Taiwan, with Malaysia, all over. We should combine. I think movie is a national language. You know, we should combine everything together.
Second question. Nowadays, the success of a film is measured by its box office result. There are some films that had a poor result at the box office, but nonetheless have greatly influenced culture and filmmaking. How do you measure the success of a film?
For me, when I was young, long time ago, the box office is very important. Because if there's no box office, nobody invite me. And money for me, making the money first, then the quality. Because I have to feed myself, I have to feed my family. And slowly, my movie success, then I would think about being an actor, a producer, director, a studio. We do have the responsibility for the society or for the world. So this why, like, make a sample, like when I make Drunken Monk, Drunken Master, you know, drinking, fighting, make a lot of money. But when I'm getting older, I think that's a wrong message. So I make Drunken Master Part 2. Don't drink, don't fight. I have to correct myself to the past when I do something wrong. And right now, When I'm making a movie, it's not box office anymore. I want to make the movie I like to make. I want to speak the things in the movie. I want every movie have a message, just like Dragon Blade. We've been talking to a director for 7 years to make that movie. Why? After I find out there's a good message. It's about peace, harmony, no war. And even the song, if tonight there's the premiere going on, please concentrate when we sing the song or you go to the internet, download the song. There's a very, very good lyric. The wind blows, the sand goes. The wind and the sand blow me to the desert, to the wall. And every day I'm thinking about home, but it's too far away. How can I go back? But when the wind, the sand stop, then the war stop. Then when the war stop, then I can go home. No, it's a very... So we spent $60 million to make that movie. Like Andrew Birdie said, if that movie making America more than $200 million, because we make it in China. And of course, box office is good, and the credit is good. That makes me happy. If the box is no good, it still makes me happy. Mostly the credit, because I speak out my message. And after you see that movie, you know what I mean. In these days, I don't need money. I have enough money already. I want to do something right for when I pass 100 years later, and your grandchildren, my grandchildren, that's the Sun movie, very good. And they are not ready to forget Drunken Master 1. They are already talking about Who Am I? They're talking about Project A. They're talking about Dragon Blade. That makes me happy. You know, Sun movie, make a lot of money. People, boom, forget. You come out of the theater, what's the movie talking about? We don't know, just ha ha ha. Right? But some movie doesn't make any money. But people, 20 years, 50 years later, still talking about, that's what I want. But when I was young, no, sorry, money first. Because I could feed myself. But this day, I want to make something nice, good, memory.
The last question. You have had an exceptional career as an actor. You started your career as a stuntman doing combat scenes and karate. Lately, however, in films like The Method, The Founding of the Republic, Dragon Blade, for example, unlike Bruce Lee, who only made combat films, you seem to have made films which are much more philosophical, with an educational aspect, highlighting the history of China. How do you see your career developing in the future?
Like I said before, before I wasn't making money, but later on, you get 2000, I changed myself. I can play Karate Kid, play the old man. Then Shinjuku's story is about don't immigrate. And I changed my character because I'm not young anymore. And also, I don't want to always make Russia 1, Russia 2, Russia 3. I'm tired to do. I want to change myself. I want to be a true actor. I want to be like a Asian Robert De Niro. Because even today, when I walk around in Africa, even in this morning, I'm walking around in the small town, you see the children. Why nobody see Robert De Niro? Robert De Niro. Why see Jackie Chan? Jackie Chan. I want 10 years later, good actor. I want to be a true actor because as action star, life very, very short. So for the last 15 years, I tried to change myself. I want to let audience know I'm the actor who can fight. It's not the actor I can. why am I always making a Chinese food? Because there's the only things I know. And in Hong Kong, I only can make police story 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Because that's what I learned from in Hong Kong. But when I go to China, okay, China history, I know. So I continue to make something about Chinese culture, collaboration with American culture. If I go to America, you give me a script, I don't know how to make. If I go to Italy, I don't know how to make Italian films. I only things can make, so I do the best I can to promote my own country, promote my own culture. That's what I'm doing.
Thank you very much for that. We have also Daniel Lee here. He's one of the biggest directors in Hong Kong now. So I really would love somebody to ask some question to Daniel Lee. As I would love to ask Emanuele Sacchi, my movies, that is on the list of the questions. Please go ahead. We can... Okay, the microphone is...
Okay. Is China finally now ready to compete with American blockbusters? And in this sense, Dragon Blade could represent the beginning of a new age, also with American actors and finally an equal state between the two countries.
Well, I've been always wish that I could have a good chance to work with American actors. Actually, for my first movie, there's one Dragon Squad that I've been working with Michael Bay. So I have some experience to work with them. But it's not the main purpose why we shoot this movie. It's just that because we come up with a good story, that is more realistic. That's why we need American actors. So the only thing that I know how to do is just concentrate to shoot the movie. So I'm 100%, you know, just focus on what I believe, what I want to do, what is what I think so excited for me to shoot this movie. So of course we all hope that, you know, after we've been stopped working with Jackie for 7 years, brainstorming the story and thinking about how to do it. Get up the morning because we need a lot of money to shoot the movie. And after the movie is born, of course we all hope that, you know, we're gonna have good results in America. And of course in every place else in the world, of course including Italy. So we all hope that the movie will be well received in the world so that people can share what we have done the past 7 years.
I don't know if you know or not. That story based in true story. Yeah, right now in Lichang, in China, Lichang, we still have that people look like Roman, but they speak Mandarin. Right now they still have a 300. Descendants after 2,000 years. They still have 300 people stay in China. They have a blue eyes, golden hair, but all like a Caucasian, but they speak Mandarin. That's based on a true story. Yeah.
It's true that this story is also quite well known in Italy because there is a book.
Oh, really?
Yes, there is a book.
Oh, good.
And it's a kind of legend, but it's based on something. As you said,
of course, you don't know what happened 2,000 years ago. We based in true story. We working on, you know, with something good. Yeah, good for Roman, good for Chinese, good for China, everything. Yeah.
Okay. C'è un'altra prenotazione in questo momento. Qualcuno da Screen Week. Avanti prima fila. Okay. Just a minute. Actually, can I ask you one question?
Yes.
About the movie tonight, because this press conference is before the screening. So I'm just the lover to ask
it's,
you.
It's all a prep. Did you see the movie yet?
Yes?
Yes.
No, because it's tonight. Yeah,
you see
here.
The movie already.
In the theaters.
Yes.
In
do you
China.
See the movie already?
Yes.
You see the movie?
No.
Do you like it? No, I'm curious, you know, because
okay.
I'm really curious.
Yes.
Do you like it?
I've seen it and I liked it a lot, especially the relationship between the squad, the Chinese squad, and the Roman inside the city when you do the exercise. With the exercise, you establish a friendship.
As long as you like it, it's good.
So the first question is, you work both of you on Dragon Blade for 7 years. For the searching and the developing of the script. Can you talk about the genesis of the project and the realization?
We both stay in Hong Kong. I have my own team. He has his own team. I never know the director. I know his name, I never met him. One day, my cameraman just right behind. He said, after editing, come back. Jackie, did you know Daniel Lee? I said, yeah, but I don't know. You should meet him. Because I trust my the cameraman editing guy. When he said, you should meet him, I know he's must be something special. Then I call, I said, hi, Daniel, because in Hong Kong, everybody call me Big Brother. I said, I'm the Big Brother, Jackie. Then he said, Jackie Chan? I said, yes. What can I do for you? I said, no, I want to meet you. I want to know you. I said, where are you? And in the office, I drive car to his office. We sit down, we talk about project. I said, what project you have? What project I have? And we sit down, we talk. I said, let's find something special. Then a month later, he said, I find out difficult to make police story, this kind of story, because you know how to make, different kind of make like a kung fu things. I have some idea. The idea come from the true story. Then we went to a bowl, I said, that's interesting. Then he do a lot of research. Then blah, 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 Roman, I said, yes, let's do it. Okay, continue.
Okay, and after we come with a mutual agreement with the subject matter, that excites both of us very much. And lately I've been doing ethics. Maybe that's the reason why Jackie wanted me to help out with this project. So we take a really long time to go over all the details. Of course, I would say nowadays Dragon Blade will be the biggest budget movie ever made in Chinese film history. So then we talk about business. Then we should make sure how we cover the box office to make it the money back. So we have a lot of consideration. And until we come with a script that Jackie liked it very much, then we start to go to the past. John Cusack and then Major Cody. And then after we lock the cast, then everything is just routine things, something like this. But one thing that I should point it out is that if you see the movie, actually, I would say two-thirds of the movie was shot in Gobi Desert in mainland China. And all the aerial shots that you see in the movie, actually, it's not by some image bank or something. We shoot it by ourselves. So it's not easy, but it's very enjoyable.
Yeah. Oh no, yeah. Enjoyable. That's you. And we have 1,000 extra in China. We don't have enough Caucasian because of Roman. we have to all over China international school to hire all the students. And oh, making a Jackie Chan film, yes, they go to like a 5-hour drive, 2-hour, 4-hour drive to the desert, and they come to meet me, and they dress up everything. They ah, Jackie, they so exciting. 2 days later,
we want to go home.
Because you just don't understand. 2:30, get up. 2.5-hour drive to the desert. Make up, armor, 200 horse, 1,000 extra to the desert, walk to the desert, because we cannot drive to the desert, because we have a every shot, we cannot have a, like the tire. Otherwise, you have to, because in China, we want to save money, not, we don't want to spend a lot of this kind of yun mong qi,
you know. Something you can.
Just don't want to waste.
Yeah,
we don't want to waste money
no
to
waste,
the special effect.
Yeah.
So all the people walk to the desert. The fifth step is okay. Then by the time you line up everybody, you teach all the students how to move. Boom, boom. From 2:30, the first shot is 11 o'clock. After finish the first shot, they will go 1:30. Then we said, okay, lunch. Gone. When they're coming back, 3 o'clock, second shot. 2,000 boxes water, 5 days gone. 200 horse. You just, and at noon, you know, the sandstorm coming, and wow, you just, 9 o'clock, still have sun. We 9:30, we finish, we go back to the hotel, sometime 11 or 11:30. You just sleep, 2:30, you get up again. For 1.5 months, all the students are gone. Nobody want to shoot movie anymore. And we invite all the press to the desert to take a look at how we make the movie. I just said, sometimes I ask the director, why we not use a green screen today? You know, we wait, you know, about 120 buses every single day. We drive, you can cover a green screen, you just shoot. He said, no, I want the real feeling, the people's feeling. Then after I realized in the Gobi Desert, there's only two directors to film there. First is Daniel Lee. Second, also Daniel Lee, nobody. He just loved the desert. When the sandstorm coming, everybody hiding. Then he just sit there with the director's chair with a louder music. He just so happy. He so enjoy. We're gonna make Dragon Bay 3 also go to desert, right?
Some places. Obviously, you know, our definition of enjoy is practical.
Okay,
the second question. Through the battles between you and Li Peng, and in the training session of the squad protection and the romance inside the Wagis Gate, the characters of the movie gain respect for each other's and forge an important friendship. As the director of the choreography, can you talk how did you devise and execute these scenes?
Well, before we're doing the shooting, you ask the director the style, what kind of style we want. We don't want like, we want everything real. In Roman fighting, bah, bah, just very tough, very strong. Not many, far how
you know? Not too much trade.
Not so much, but in Chinese, we have a lot of, but Roman, bah, 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 it's different kind of fighting. And also we don't like use a special effect, flying around like a crouching tiger. that I don't think audience like these kind of things. But right now there's too many movies, like the modern movie, the
period
movie, everybody flying around. Even a modern film, bang, bang. It's ridiculous. So I said, we have to make the reality movie. Yeah, how we can, nobody can, from the horse jump to the horse, nobody can the roof to jump to the roof, we do the real things. So when you see the Dragon Blade, everything you see is the real. And we just, 人可以做到的事,
anything real
here. 不是普通人可以做到,
not just ordinary people can. Not because it's ordinary people, but has to be something humanly possible. Realistic.
Something like that.
Something like that.
it's mean. Seems everybody can do it. But not everybody can do it.
Okay.
Only some stunt guy or me or some people who train can do it. But you believable. Oh yes, that's people can do it. Yeah.
Okay. Ma in lunghissima non le sa chi ha ancora una domanda sia per Mr. Jackie Chan che per Mr. Daniel Lee. Another question for both.
Huh? Yes.
Another question is coming.
In this CGI digital world full of technology, the purity of the gesture of the martial art, there's still space and future for this, for the real thing, for stunts like yours, for example, Police Story or other pictures. We can see, can still see something of this, of the real thing, or technology will prevail.
I think slowly the real action's gone, really. Because even now we still have a few people to do the real stunt, real action, like Ong Bak, like me, like Sammo Hung, like some other, yeah. But when these people's gone, when we retire, I think slowly, because the real action is really difficult. But in America, they're so good, they're so clever, they can use the special effects, computer graphic, to make everybody becoming an action star. And even you can be an action star, even you became an action star. But I want to do these kind of things. When I was young, we don't have money, we have to do the real stuff. We have to, from the building jump to the building. And you know, I cracked my feet, I broke my finger, I broke everything. But when I have money, I do have money to do special effects, but the audience, they don't like it. They want to see Jackie Chan, how he hurt himself. And they want to see Jackie Chan do the real things. Even now, they say, oh, Jackie, you're not young anymore. But it doesn't matter, I want to see you still how high you can jump. Okay, I still get one kick, wow, good. But they just don't like, the audience, they just don't like see Jackie do a Superman. Like Spider-Man, so easy, right? You cover, you move, cut. Then everything special effect. Then coming back, I want to do that. Director, hire me. But no director hire me to do these kind of things. They want me, okay, Russia 1, Russia 2, Russia. Just do the own. I said, I cannot jump over the table. No, okay, you can jump over the chair. They still want me to do these kind of things. But I think after Sammo Hung, me, and this guy retire, slowly the young generation is changed. Now they already learn how to use a special effect, how to use the trick. We poor me. Now we know how to use the trick. But the audience, they still want to see the real things. I will continue to do another 5 more years, I think. Yeah. Then after 5 years, adios. Then I do a love scene.
Ancora una. another one.
And you talk about the new generation. With all the martial artists around, there is one in particular that you can pick and choose.
So many. Honestly, even my JC team, my young guy, I see so many. But they just so good, but because they are not popular and nobody hired them. If there's a big studio, because there's only one Jackie Chan, I already trained so many, my JC team already. If the big studio, like big director, they can hire a young generation, they can spend $100 million or even $500 million to make a movie with them, I think they're becoming a superstar. There's so many, you know, parkour, you know, you can see the internet, there's so many young people, so good. I just, wow, even me, I'm saying so good. But how you make, some fight very good, they cannot act. They can jump for 10 buildings, but they cannot act. That's difficult. You have to train them as an action star, not like a long time ago. You just fight, you become an action star. But these days, you have to act. Do stunt, fight, comedy, drama, everything. This is very difficult. It's not just, I know how to fight. It's not fighting. Now the audience will see everything.
Boys are.
Andrea,
Natalia Coxo, che può fare altre domande, che sarebbe un po'. The first question is for Daniel Lee. It's about his third film, I think it is. Till Death Do Us Part. I think that movie is one of the best daring films of the 90s in Hong Kong. But after that film, after the three films that you made, is What Price of Survival, then Black Mask, and then Till Death Do Us Part, you change a little bit the style. It's more less dark and less daring. I want to know why you change the style in now it's a more mainstream.
It's very simple because I grew up. I'm different. I'm not like 20 years because that movie is 1996, almost 20 years ago. I think director shouldn't stay on the same mentality all the time, even though he wants to. But you know, we have our own life experience. You know, we change. You know, I tell you a secret. I shot that movie. I love that movie, but I never see that movie again. Yeah, never. I'm scared. Last time I said, you know, because it's about the book of marriage, I want to shoot the psychological realistic things there. So I do all my use all my language, all my tools to shoot it as powerful as possible. But now today, you know, if I'm old, I'm so scared. Even myself, I don't want to see that movie. Maybe after 5 or 4 years, then I will check it out. And I'm not agree that I change a lot. Actually, the language, the photography, the way I have shoot the movie, actually I remain almost more or less the same. Even Dragon Blade, even the epics that I shot a couple of years ago. So the documentary style about action, I still keep it. And it's just that I changed, you know, and epic actually that I've done from my past 8 years, it's really the other side of myself. You know, I'm the kind of people that I can't adapt myself too much. I can shoot only what I'm excited and believe.
The second question is for Jackie Chan.
It's
about Mr. Canton and Lady Rose and the Project Up Part 2. I think the dog film is more stylish than the other films you made. It seems that you want to demonstrate to be a true director. And Mr. Canto and the Rose is very stylish with the steadicam and the musical part and other things. So the project that is like a slapstick movie, like Buster Keaton or the other, like the Last Hunt. don't know if at the moment you wanted to do straight, if you are a real director and not only a...
When I think I'm very lucky. I have a few things breaking an Asian record. I'm the youngest stunt coordinator when I was 18. And also I'm the youngest director in Hong Kong. I don't know in Asia. I was 22, already being a director. And like, Phil was a hyena, young master, Dragon Law, I'm continuing to do these kind of things. And that time in Hong Kong, we don't have a director skill. We just, you have your part, you have your part. I hear somebody, because my movie always number one box office. Maybe somebody don't like him. Ah, techie. He only know how to make action film. That makes me angry. So this is why I make Little Candle in the Rose.
Yes.
I spent almost $3 million to buy the best camera equipment from England, Technovision. It's not Panavision, it's Technovision. And I get a super bullet, all the lighting, and I hire all the lighting in Hong Kong, and I rent everything. And 7 days for one shot. And I moved the small mountain to build the set to do the steady cam. And 16 hours for one shot. You know, I just want to show the director who said, Jackie don't know how to direct, just action move. I want to show the director, you cannot do it, only I can do it. But after the movie comes out, I'm so stupid. I said, why when people say something and change these kind of things? And you know, at that time, still young, everything I wanted to be a number one. But today it changed. And sometimes you do need the skill to show audience. And sometimes if I ask you, if you see the Dragon Blade, what kind of camera we use, you don't know. What kind of lighting we use, you don't know. The audience sit down, ha ha ha, good movie, bad movie, that's all. You don't have to spend 2 months to do one shot. The audience, they not appreciate it. They just come to see good movie or bad movie, that's all. That's how I learned. So later on, I just want to pick a movie. I don't want to show the skill. This kind of, today the skill is so easy. You just special effect and computer graphic. But I just want to show you, that's how I move it. One shot, pa, 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 pa. I don't want to use a small trick. Pa, ka, 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 ka. I show you the how movement, pa, 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 shum, and second shot. That's how I show the audience.
Okay, Tina Bernik from Slovenia. Now, okay. We are on the border between Italy and Slovenia. And we have journalists from there. Please go ahead.
Since I come from an ex-Yugoslavian country, I'm interested. Are your memories of Yugoslavia only painful?
Big memory. I will never, never forget. I almost died in Yugoslavia.
Yeah.
Zagreb. My God.
You fractured your skull.
Yes, I fractured my skull from 8:30. I fractured my skull from the mountain, moved down for 2 hours. Go to the hospital and injection. After that, they put everything out, moved to another hospital. And everybody called, everybody crying. Everybody thought, I'm dying. Yes, Jackie's gone. All the blood, from my ear, Yugoslavia.
Yeah, my question was, are you, the memories of Yugoslavia only painful, or
no,
are
they... it's a memory, yes. And yes, it's a, the movie is a very successful around the world. Yeah.
The other thing you forgot, because of the fracture.
Yes, everything you forget.
How do you look on the development of Chinese cinematography? Do you miss more activist films, critical films to the government, or do you prefer that it stays in the realm of martial arts movies and epic war movies?
Yeah. I think I have my own way. I already planned for my next almost 8 years. All my script. Next month I would we start a movie. It's called Railroad Tiger, something like that. Okay. Later on might change. I just directly translate Railroad Tiger. It's about 30s. And then Stanley Tong, director, who directed Rambo in the Bronx, and we're doing a Kung Fu Yoga in India. And after that, after Kung Fu Yoga, man. Yeah, civilian director probably is Pete Siegel, director Pete Siegel. Then probably foreigner Michael Campbell. Then come back, director again. And like 30s in Shanghai Tang. And 12 Zodiac 2, myself direct again. And there's just so many things going on. I think just, I like to challenge. Every movie is different. After the 12 Zodiac, and I make like the Police Story 2013. Very drama. Then I like Dragon Blade. I want audience to see every year different Jackie Chan. This year Christmas will be a Skip Trace. It's an action comedy with Johnny Knoxville. Yeah, it's a comedy, action comedy. I think you just do the right things, the right message, and I think almost, probably everything is about harmony, peace, you know, this kind of message. That's my future, to do all the movies.
You once said that you love action, but you hate violence. This is kind of a conflict of interest. How do you deal with it?
Very, very dilemma. Action, always people think action is a violence. So this one, all those years, I use the action combined with a comedy. It's a quite dilemma. Yes, you're right. But I just do the best I can to show the whole world. You know, violence is wrong. No, violence is wrong.
Thank you, Sabina.
Please go ahead.
Please, the microphone.
One, two, three.
I was ready.
Our impression that you have confirmed is that Hollywood is producing less film involving a real martial artist than in the past. What is changing the world of action movies? And is there any movie you have enjoyed?
Because a martial art movie is difficult to shoot. It's very difficult. It's not easy. You know, you have to the actor who can really fight. Then you can and use a sofa, everything. But honestly, in Hollywood, not many actors know martial art. Maybe they know action, like Tom Cruise, Tom Cruise. Stallone, they like boxing. It's different kind. So if they use a special effect, like Batman, Superman, good. They can use a special, do all kind of action. Sometimes the action better than my action. They combine with the 300, boom, so even myself, wow, so good. So that's, spend a lot of money in the room to create this kind of action, I think 10 times better than I am. But they really use the action.
Like that,
Neiman Nelson. He's not the action star, but they can use a small shot. Let him become an action star. Yeah, in the, and there's some actor action star. There's some action star. It's different. Now, Neiman Nelson is an actor action star. First, he can act, but action easy. There's a easy action, different co-action. Easy action just like Matt Damon, and Bond Identity. They can use a camera. So good, even I see, wow, Matt Damon can fight that good. No, my kind of action is difficult action. Why? I put the camera like this. Not use a small tight shot. Just boom, 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 boom. Even cross, pow, that's difficult. That's the difficult, that depends on what kind you see. But the audience, they don't know. They just, wow, good, bad, that's all.
There are a lot of rumors.
Even in Hollywood right now, you don't have to do this. You just empty. Right? I just, wow, this is so easy. When I make Shanghai Noon, the two tomahawk, really tomahawk, I use my stunt team. Okay, one, okay? Actually, one, two, three, boom! Tomahawk, the really tomahawk. So stupid. These days, nothing. Ha ha ha, action. Wait. You know how stupid I am? What happened? Oh, I'm dying. But it's different. When I use an explosion, I want to use a really explosion behind me. Sometimes making a Hollywood film, action, scared. Ah, nothing. Nothing behind. It's just you pretend scared. Okay. Ah. But when you see the Asian film, what I made, really scared. When you're in the house, there's a dynamite everywhere. You just boom, 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 boom. Action. You can tell from the face. Ah. Maybe I like chicken. Maybe I like excitement. Yeah. Stupid. But sometimes I like stupid. And also the audience, they like to see Jackie stupid.
We love it.
Yes, we do.
There are a lot of rumors about a sequel to The Karate Kid. But we'll see you again in the Mr. Anne shoes. Do you have any news for us?
Right now, 大幾版. Yeah, now it's almost the third or fourth
draft.
Four draft right now. And Will Smith, very, very...
I'm very
seriously...
Yeah,
serious, to concentrate. Yeah, every time they give me a call, Jackie, and the script almost ready. And I said, hurry up, otherwise your son taller than me. Right? Yeah, now he was 16 now. He's about like this high. Jaden. Yeah. 18? God. I met how many years ago? 6 years ago? Yeah, they said, Jackie, what are we working on? We're working on, yeah. But probably there's a Shanghai Dawn coming. Rush Hour 4.
Okay, the last question from...
No, I'm just joking. Joking, huh? Don't type, joking.
Okay, the last question from... the journalist from the campus, because we have a journalist school during the festival, the film festival. Who is the girl? No? This one? Sure? Okay. Can you pass the microphone?
And how do you feel about the fact that Wuxia and and the tradition of martial arts you were raised on have become the predominant style of action across global cinema.
Of course, I'm very happy because
my ancestor, my mentor,
like we're talking about long time ago, Wang Yu, Bruce Lee, and so there's so many. Then I follow their step, continue to promote our culture to the world. I believe after me, there's so more people still continue my step. Just like there's so many American director, American actor promote American culture to the world. Same thing, we accept the culture, we learn the culture, and also now we try to return some of our culture. If everybody knows everybody's culture, there's no more war. And no more misunderstand. I think movie, music is very important. Yeah.
Okay, so thank you very much for your time here. Thank you to